Today you will buy a loan for 7 days, then you will buy it for 7 weeks, then you will buy it for 7 months, 7 years, and then you are stuck in debt. Hello and Namaste Paycheck Pros. I'm Manish Ahuja and this is Paycheck to Profit, India's first YouTube channel dedicated to your financial freedom. On this channel, I make new videos on 4th, 14th and 24th of every month where I talk to you about how you can invest your money, how you can grow your money and eventually how you can earn your financial freedom through your paycheck. Before I get started, a very happy anniversary to all of you viewers. Yes, this is our first anniversary video. I'm not the kind of a person who will make a big bang about it. I just talk about it. I just want to celebrate it with you because without you, this channel and this entire concept of making these videos would not have been possible. So very warm-hearted thank you for watching these videos, subscribing to the channel, and if you haven't subscribed to the channel, dude, we are on 1 year. Please give me an anniversary gift and subscribe to the channel. Also make sure that you tap on the bell icon so that you get notified every time I make a new video. In today's video, I'm going to be talking to you about 5 areas in which you end up getting a loan, or 5 reasons why you get a loan which you don't need to, or which you should rather avoid as much as possible. The first and the most common way in which people end up taking loans is buying electronics on EMIs. Why would you want to buy an electronic on monthly basis installments? Obviously, electronics are good. They make our life convenient. They are really important. We use them every day. We can't live without these cell phones. You're probably watching this video on your cell phone. But still, today, most phones work more or less the same. Obviously, I cannot compare a 20,000 worth of a phone to a 1.5 lakh rupee worth of a phone. Yes, there is going to be a huge difference between these two phones, but still, even a 20, 30, 40,000 worth of a phone does its job, right? It's my request to you to be a little prudent about electronics because you will always be tempted to buy the next best version. Ask me, I am one of those people who's been bitten by the bug, but I make sure I never buy an electronic on EMI. I would rather save my money, buy that electronic 6 months down the line than buy a phone which I can't afford. Second way where you end up taking a loan without even realizing, or an expense that you can avoid, is lifestyle expenses. Going to the mall, departmental stores. Today everything is available on EMI. Every time I go outside a departmental store during the sales season, I see like these big banners saying everything on EMI. Just swipe your card and the entire amount of your shopping gets divided in equal monthly installments. All of these expenses add up. All of these EMIs catch up. You end up spending a lot of money in these EMIs. You don't even realize when you stop going from a 0% EMI to 1%, 2%, 5%, 10% EMI loans, which really add up over a period of time. If you can live without it, please don't buy it today. There will always be a better day when you can buy more and more of these things when you need them. Yet another way banks and financial institutions force you, or rather cajole you into buying things on loans, is by giving you debit card and credit card EMIs. You will go and buy something that you can afford with your debit card, you get your card swiped, and immediately you'll get a call. Sir, you know what, you've bought something, many congratulations, and now we will give you an option to convert this expense into an EMI. The reason why banks are doing this, or the reason why financial institutions are doing this, is because they want people to get into the EMI culture. They want people to get used to loans so that they get more and more business out of the interest that they earn. Fourth way that is getting really popular with regards to loans is a concept called as a salary day loan. Let's say you're watching this video on 24th of February. It's really close to the end of the month. February still has less days. Let's say it's May and you have 31 days to go. You have an entire week to go and you're running low on cash. And you'll see an ad pop up on your social media channel and you'll see get a loan of 10,000 rupees only by paying 200 rupees extra. What is this 200 rupees extra? It's interest. What is the 10,000 rupees? It's a small term loan. It's a salary day loan. It's nothing but making you get used to the concept of loans. Today you will buy a loan for 7 days, then you will buy it for 7 weeks, then you will buy it for 7 months, 7 years, and then you are stuck in debt. Please avoid buying these loans. Please manage your expenses better. Please budget your expenses so that you don't reach a position that you have to buy a salary day loan towards the end of the month. As simple as that. The fifth and yet another lifestyle expense that tempts you to buy a product much over your regular budget is either cars or bikes. Today, we spend a lot of time commuting, especially if you're living in cities where cars and bikes are not really a luxury but a necessity. But you know what do people end up doing? They end up buying bikes worth 2, 3, 4 lakh rupees. You know what they do? They buy cars worth 15 lakh rupees where they can actually start with an hatchback. I have met so many people who refuse to buy a hatchback just because the whole allurement of getting a sedan or a salon is much better than driving a hatchback. I'm not trying to be judgmental here. I'm just trying to tell you, please be careful about your expenses. That sedan can wait. 2 years down the line, when your salary has reached a particular scale and when you know you can afford that sedan a lot better, that is the time when you should look for a sedan. Maybe you can look for a second-hand sedan rather than buying a brand new one. I'm just trying to tell you, find a way. If you want to buy the best one, if you want to shop every 3 months in a mall using EMIs, if you want to take salary day loans, and if you still want to buy that sedan, something is definitely wrong with your earning and spending patterns. The purpose of this video is not to scare you, Paycheck Pros. It's just to make you aware about all the pitfalls with which you can get tempted to buy things or buy things on EMI or loans without even realizing the kind of mistakes or financial goof-ups that you're making. I hope this video has helped you in a way to open your eyes. If you know of somebody who makes expenses on EMIs, please do them a favor by sharing this video with them. And if you like this video, please do not forget to hit the like button. That's about it from me in today's video. Now I'll see you in the next video. Until then, please keep smiling, take care of your loved ones, and stay happy. Ka-ching!